Hello students, today we will discuss new poem, poem number 5th. In this, the title it is given Roadside Stand and poet is Robert Frost. So here period it is mentioned 1874 to 1963. So this poet is specially here it is mentioned highly acclaimed American poet, and the period it is mentioned of 20th century. And Robert Frost poems are concerned about what? So here 2-3 things mentioned that I will refer for you in this. Point number one, his poems are concerned with human tragedies. Number one is human tragedies and fears. And then his reaction to the complexities of life and his ultimate acceptance of his burdens. So Robert Frost focused on the things, and here some important well-known poems. It is also mentioned in about the poet. First one, Stopping by the Woods on a Snowy Evening. So this is well-known work. Then Birches, and then third, Mending Walls are a few of his well-known poems. So today the poem which we are here discussing, that is a Roadside Stand. Here it is given about that a roadside stand. Frost peasants, lives of poor deprived people, with pitiless clarity and with deepest sympathy and humanity. So here, before starting the actual poem discussion, first we will think about the last three lines. In that last three lines, what are the important highlights given? In this, we can have one important here word, that is poor deprived people. And here poet is talking about the poor people, and that poor people are deprived people. So, and one more thing here, means deprived means they are away from the stream, mainstream of the civilization. One more thing here, with pitiless clarity. And here poet is talking about the clear view, clear vision, their pathetic condition. It is clearly mentioned in the poem. So here Robert Frost observation of the deprived people, especially the mountain area. In this poem, it is about the mountain area, remote area, village or the countryside. All that setting here, we will think about all that things concerned with the poem. Then, one more again, with pitiless clarity and with deepest sympathy and humanity. So here, one more thing it is, with deepest sympathy and humanity. So when we are reading the poem, we feel sympathy for the people, those who are living in mountain ranges or countryside people, or they are away from the city area and they are not having more facilities, and especially their economic condition, it is not good. So, think in that important aspect, that their pathetic condition, it is clearly observed, and here in the poem it is presented. And one more thing, the humanity approach, it is here purposefully used. Means when we are reading poem, we feel that we should also help the person who is in need, especially those who are the deprived people, or in our also country means India, there are so many areas where till the civilized world is not observed, especially the tribal area people, they are still away from the mainstream of the education. They are not getting that quality education till. So many issues are there because connectivity problems, their language issues, so many problems are there. So here poet is talking about the American village countryside area, and that people, they are facing so many problems, especially about their daily wages, how they are living their life in pathetic condition. So here the title it is given, a roadside stand. So this, it is not the stand which we are thinking that a railway station or bus stand or like that, it is not the thing. But here stand refers to the shade. And what is that shade, all things? Now we will start. Here before you read in this, it is given, have you ever stopped at a roadside stand? What have you observed there? So if we will take the example of here Konkan area, you can observe, especially Mumbai Goa highway, there are also such type of roadside stand or roadside seats, where especially means Konkan area, whatever here we are, means the farmers, they are producing especially mangoes. So many people, what they are doing, they are selling the mangoes. So such type of means market here, it is not like a mall or something, but they will create with the nearby area, whatever they will get, that said maybe not, it should not be like the mall or something which is constructed properly, but whatever the material they will get, using that material, here also we are observing. So same thing in the poem, it is also described. So I will begin the poem here. The little old house was out with the little new shade, and there was one small house, and it was extended, and that extended part, little bit expansion of that same house, and it is created in a sense of shade, and they are selling the things, means vegetables or goods, whatever it is there with them, especially they are the farmers, and whatever it will produce in the farm, they will sell in that shade, and especially that shades are nearby the highway. The little old house was out with a little new shade, and in front at the edge, means the corner, at the edge of the road where the traffic sped, where the traffic it is with the speed, sped means here speed, so traffic it is with the speed, and in that situation here poet is observing, and that observation it is mentioned in the next line, that is a roadside stand that too pathetically plead. And the roadside stand, it is actually pleading, pathetic condition, it is not good, very means worse condition. So in that pathetically, that the shade, the roadside stand, it, the shade, it is pathetically pleading, requesting. To plead means request, and that is their genuine request. So here any inanimate object cannot have such type of feelings, means a roadside stand or the shade, but here the roadside stand or the shade, it is personified. So personification poetic device, so note it down in your notebook, this is important because it may be asked for the exam. Then one more thing here, pathetically played, in this alliteration, beginning two consonant sounds, so pathetic in this per sound and played also per sound. So two consonant sounds are there in consecutive words. So here also alliteration poetic device you can notice. So this poem, it is full of poetic devices, literary devices are used. So it may be for one mark, because in 12th this year also question paper design, 4 marks question will be asked, extract from the poem will be given, and they will ask one mark question. So in that 1 mark there may be poetic device they may ask. They may ask the meaning of the phrase, they may ask the meaning of the word, or concerned with that, any question, extract based question would be asked. So everyone, and there is no or question given. Previous means 2 years back, you can observe the structure in that or question was there. But last year they have changed the structure, and same this year also structure would be same. It is announced. So what you have to do here? In front, at the edge of the road where the traffic speed, roadside stand that too pathetically played. It would not be fair to see for a dole of bread. And they are not pleading. They are not pleading for the dole of bread. It would not be fair to say like this, that they are not the beggars. They are living in mountain ranges. They are deprived. They are away from the main city. But it doesn't mean that they are there like a beggars. Whatever they will produce in the farm, whatever it would be available in that area, they will keep it in that shed for sale. And it would be their genuine request, genuine expectation from the city dwellers, city people, that city people should come and they should purchase something because they have the money. So if they will spend some money or purchasing, because here we can notice 3 observations. One is here, whatever the things they will produce, there is no such type of things they will use, chemical or something. So you will get fresh material, fresh vegetables. And second thing, it would be in cheap rate, because here other all values, means how in mall or they are increasing the price. Transportation, all that things are not there. So price would be less. They would get that fresh material in cheap price also, and quality also. And they can bargain as well. So here the things, all that positive things are there for the city area people. And what is their expectation? That at least some city people, they should visit that roadside stand or the shed, and they must purchase something. So their economic condition, they will get some money, and that some money would be utilized for their daily lives. So here poet is mentioning that, but some of the money in cash. So here some of the money, the cash. But here poet is expecting that they want some money in cash. So here the cash whose flow supports the flower of the city is from sinking and withering faint. So here it is mentioned pathetically played, we have discussed, and this is example of alliteration as well. Then for dole of bread, here dole of bread in a sense that they are not asking you, or they are not waiting there as like a beggar to give something, or on the charity base or something to donate, or they are not asking because it is their hard work, and through that hard work they are doing, and they have just kept all the things. But you can understand now also in India, so many farmers they are facing problems. They don't know how to do marketing all. So sometime if they would not get the price which is expected by them, so they are doing suicide. You can read. So every year or the same situation, it is still there. This year also it is happening. So previous all years, if you will take the report, in that you can understand that why they are taking such type of decisions, because they are not getting enough money in that firm. So such type of year also in America, your poet observed the condition of mountain ranges, that countryside area, and in that countryside area, how farmers, especially those who are deprived from, they are away from the main city, how they are facing the problem, it is here discussed. So here poet is using the word flower of cities. So this year flower of cities, it is metaphor. So here flower of cities refers to the people, those who are living in that countryside area, village area, remote area, mountain ranges area. And here, whose flow supports the flower of cities from sinking and withering faint. How is the flower? When you pluck out the flower, what will happen? Slowly, 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 if they means when it is attached to the plant, then there would not be problem from. But here, once we will pluck out that flower, water source, everything, they will not get. Here also same thing. If mountain ranges people or countryside people, if they will not get money, how they will survive? One day it will happen that they will also do suicide or something. They will also quit their life. So it is everyone's responsibility to provide them support. And what is the support? Poet is expecting the some money in cash. So now you are the city dwellers, so you give some money to them, and they are not asking like a dole of bread. So they are not asking for that. So here they are doing hard work in the farm, and then they are selling that fresh vegetables or materials or the goods, whichever it is available in that area. So here, for that sake, the here image of the withering flower. So how the flower withers slowly, 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 and the charm of the fragrance of the flower slowly, slowly decrease. So like that, here the people, those who are living in that area, they are pathetically pleading. They are waiting for the customers, they are waiting for the city dwellers, that city dwellers will come and they will purchase the material or the whatever the things they have kept for the selling. So this is very important here aspect here, from sinking and withering faint. Poet use very nice words, perfect words, to describe the pathetic condition of the village people. So here especially poor deprived people, and with pitiless clarity. So in the beginning also itself, here in the about the author, it is mentioned here with pitiless clarity. Clarity here, with clarity, and when we are reading this poem, we feel sympathy for the people, those who are living in that area. Means in which area you are living, it is not important, but as a citizen, how you are cooperating others, and how you are thinking about others, how you are contributing in the progress of the nation, or you have that mutual understanding, it is important. So city people should have that mutual understanding and that awareness. Means there is no such type of awareness that they are not thinking about others if they have that money. Again, one more here, the policed traffic. So here the word policed traffic, it is the example of transferred epithet. In this flower of cities, it is example of metaphor, indirect comparison with the, means the condition of the farmers, condition of the poor people, poor deprived people, it is compared with the flower. Indirectly, how the flower withers slowly, slowly, if they will not get the money, their lives will be also in the end, means they will also do the suicide, or they may have such type of problems if they will not get, means that economic crisis, due to economic crisis, anything may happen to them. The polished traffic passed with the mind ahead. So this, the word polished here, it is polished in a sense. So here this, the word polished, why the word polished is used, polished traffic, they are the sophisticated people, educated people. And the poetic device is here, transferred epithet. So traffic is never polished. Here more also examples of the same it is given. So here poet is using such type of words to highlight the situation. How is the traffic? Traffic, it is like a polished traffic, means actually the people, those who are traveling from that road, they are the educated people, city people. So here sophisticated people, the image of the sophisticated people, here poet used the word polished traffic. So here polished traffic passed with a mind ahead, but they are passing through that road with a mind ahead and they are not looking at that shade. So they should notice, they should go there, visit that shade and ask for the some vegetables or the things and purchase that. That is more important. Or if ever aside a moment, then out of sort at having a landscape marred with artless paint. So here again poet used the thing, that is out of sort, means they are not thinking in that condition. Okay, there is no such type of any notice, or they are not thinking to help them, which unmindful way. Or here one more thing notice, you can, having a landscape marred with artless paint, what is, instead of looking at the roadside stand, where they will look, where they would observe, what they will observe, they will observe here at having the landscape marred with artless paint of signs, that with N turned wrong and S turned wrong. So while going, they will observe the sign, means sign of N, sign of S, means N means here north, S south. So that directions, and it is landscape marred. Marred means spoiled, spoiled with artless paint. So deprived people, poor deprived people, their education, due to lack of education or quality education or the art, they are not the painters. So they might have done that thing, and that art it is, or the painting, or that direction of N or S, it may not be painted as like city people. So here at having the landscape marred with the artless paint of signs, that with N turn wrong and S turn wrong. The strokes may not be good, it may not look proper. So they may notice that and they may ask about that, but they may not purchase the things which are there for the sale. So they may comment on that. So here at having a landscape marred with the artless paint and of signs, that with N turn wrong and S done wrong, offered for sale. So here now poet is mentioning two, three things in that offered for sale wild berries in wooden cords. So here cords meaning it is given bottles or containers of wooden. And then means sell wild berries example or crook-neck golden squash with silver wards. So here squash means a kind of vegetable guard like that. So here two examples given just as a representing the things what would be there. The reader should get the idea. So in that and some words here used with silver wards. So if you will just observe the image of that, you can Google it and see that how the silver wards means on that squash look like. So you will get that clear image. So just here two examples given. One is wild berries and crook-neck golden squash with silver wards. Or beauty rests in a beautiful mountain scene. Or beauty rests in a beautiful mountain scene. The area it is actually beautiful. Why? The mountain ranges, then nice landscapes, fresh air, very calm and peaceful atmosphere, soothing atmosphere, because it is countryside area. Pollution would be less, means the area density would be less, very less people in mountain ranges you can observe. So here such type of things, but due to the road connectivity, they are taking that benefit to construct a shed. And here their house, little house, they have just expanded that house and they prepared one shed, and in that shed they are selling. So now here you have the money. So poet is saying you have the money, means he is saying to the city people that you have the money, but if you want to be mean, so here in a different way poet is saying what is the why you keep money this crossly. So here poet is aggressive, in angry mood poet is saying why you keep your money and go along, why you are keeping that money with you, why you are not purchasing the things which are required. So this is the very important thing that we have to notice here, that poet is here saying, referring that why keep your money this crossly, means in angry mood, and go along, and you are going or passing through that area without purchasing the things. If you have money then purchase. And the hurt to the scenery wouldn't be my complaint. So here poet is referring that hurt to the scenery, it is not never my complaint, there is no complaint. So suppose you are coming as a tourist, you are visiting that place, and if you will spoil some, means the beauty or the things whichever it is available there, or little bit hurt to the scenery, it would not be complaint. But when you will go there, when you will visit that area, the economy of that area or the economic condition of that people will have that lift, requisite lift, but you are not purchasing, so their economic condition is day by day deteriorating, because how they will again arrange the transportation, and they will go in the city and they will sell that things, and they are not having that marketing. So many issues are there, means knowledge here difference, because they are the poor deprived people. So here poet is saying that the hurt to the scenery wouldn't be my complaint. So this is not at all the complaint poet is saying, but when it is not a complaint, when you will purchase. So this thing we can notice here. Then so much as the trusting sorrow of what is unsaid. So much of trusting sorrow. So now here, what kind of trusting sorrow, what would be their trust? And what would be the sorrow? They would also expect from the city people that city people will come there. And what they will do? They will purchase their things. And it is their expectation, genuine expectation. So they would keep trust in that thing. And what will happen? If they would think in this modern life, all that expectation, and it would be unsaid. So they may not say all that things to others now, that their expectations are not fulfilled. So here, they are having that condition of unhappiness, state of mind, due to the people, those who are passing that area, they are not purchasing the things. So here, so much as the trusting sorrow of what is unsaid. Here, far from the city, we make our roadside stands. The poet is referring here that they are constructing such type of roadside stands. They are far away from the city. So here, far from the city, we make our roadside stand and ask for some city money to fill in hand. And they are just asking for the some money, not more, to fill in their hand. But how they are expecting? They are expecting in cash that something they will get, some money they will get, and they will survive on that money. So here far from the city, we make our roadside stand and ask for some city money to fill in hand. One more here thing here, to try if it will not make our being expand. So if you will give some money, it doesn't mean that our lives will suddenly expand and we will get so all the facilities, luxurious facilities. But with your help, the flowers, so your earlier line it is, the flower of cities from sinking and withering faint, means whose flow supports. So your flow or your money would support us. So suddenly our beings will not expand, we will not become suddenly rich. So here it is, and to try if it will not make our being expand, suddenly it will, but at least we can survive. And give us the life of the moving picture promise. So moving picture promise here, the dreams, American here especially dreams, and moving picture promise in another also way, we can here think that everybody is dreaming, but that dream here sometimes feel like a moving picture promise. And especially here one more line, that the party in power is said to be keeping from us, that the party in power, they will also show some agenda, they will also show, or they will also mention in their agenda so many things that we will do this for you. And we may keep that trust on them, and we, in the future what will happen? They may not pay attention towards their own agenda. And the same thing you can observe in, means America, here the condition of America here it is described. And we can observe the such type of situation. Means the ruling parties, they are also not there keeping promise. So here the word moving picture promise, so how would be that promise? The promises from the ruling party, the government, sometime they may not fulfill, they may not complete the target or whatever the promise they will give or the plans they will announce, it may not be completed. Sometime it would be just as a plan. So here, give us the life of the moving picture promise. that the party in power is said to be keeping from us, and they may keep it away from all that things. And what will happen then? So much as the trusting sorrow of what is unsaid, and due to the expectations, again that trusting sorrow, they may think that they may have trust on the government. Some means in the initial stage, whenever any new government would come, and they may expect from that they would have a good governance, and they would announce good plans, or in their budget they would announce the projects. But up till the period of time, or that may be 5 years or whatever the period would be, in different countries it may be different. So here, whatever the period of that ruling party, they may just announce at the beginning, but may not fulfill the things which they would announce, may not complete the projects which they would have announced in their agenda or the government portfolio. So here, up till this, poet is mentioning all that things in detail. Means it is not only the thing about the city people. So your poet is including the government as well here. And in the next stanza, poet is involving the government as well as the businessmen also indirectly. So that we will here think. It is in the news that all these pitiful kin. It is in the news that all these pitiful kin. So your pitiful kin refer to the village, the poor deprived people. It is referred to the village area people, poor deprived people. That pitiful, the word pitiful, it is used. So we feel sympathy for them because they are the poor farmers, and they have just expanded their little house, and they created the roadside stand or the roadside shed. Pitiful kin. It is in the news that all these pitiful kin are to be bought out and mercifully gathered in to live in the villages. Now, those who are living in that mountain ranges, nearby, especially nearby the highway or the road, now their transportation facility, it is there. So what will happen here? Their lands, their farm, businessmen along, means businessmen with the help of government, they will purchase. There would be deal with the businessmen and the government. And what they will announce, the area, that area they will announce, maybe industrial area, industrial zone or something, and they will take out all that people from that area. What would be the benefit? That it is clearly here mentioned, that are to be bought out and mercifully gathered. And how it is mercifully they will gather them, means they will not have that much respect. They will just announce for them so many things, but in reality they may not get the facilities which they would announce properly. So here, mercifully gathered in to live in villages. So here, little bit big towns, nearby that towns, they may give some area to live for them. And nearby that, what are the facilities? Next to the theater and the store. So theaters would be there, stores would be there, means nearby area facilities are there, little bit civilized area. They will bring all the people, those who are living in that area, they will purchase their land, and they will promise them that we will provide you all the facilities, then why you are in worry? Here in that roadside stand, you are not getting the money, so better you come there, you sell your land, we will purchase your land, and you will not face any problem because all things are nearby that place. So we are next to the theater and the store, where they won't have to think for themselves anymore. So you do not have any problem there. You don't have to think of yourself because here all facilities you will get in that area, nearby area. So here, but now here poet is criticizing the government and the businessmen both. While greedy good doers, so here this greedy good doers, it is here poetic device, oxymoron, and one more here, greedy good, in this alliteration is also used. So greedy good doers, so greedy and good, so two opposite things, two opposite ideas here it is mentioned. So it is here oxymoron. So greedy, how greedy will be good? So greedy good doers means, especially here author is mentioning the businessmen, they are the greedy good doers, beneficent beast of prey. So here beneficent beast of prey, beast of prey, this is also here beneficent and beast, this is also example of oxymoron, poetic device, beneficent and beast, two opposite things are there. And here beast of prey means especially those who are the big animals, what they will do, they will kill the small ones. Like that here very poor, deprived people, their lives they will completely, they will spoil, they will take away their natural method of living life, means every day they have to go in the farm and do hard work, it is their natural way of living life. But what they will do, they will take out that things from them. So here it is clearly mentioned that beneficent beast of prey soar over their lives in forcing benefits, and what they will do, they will soar over their lives and they will show that we are providing you all the material, and they will focus, they will do advertisement that you are getting so many benefits if you are selling your land, your lives would have more, means better life, how the city area people or the town, especially the little bit big town, how they are living their life, and they are getting all facilities, means they can go in the theater, they can watch movie or so many things, and nearby market it is there, so many things are there. So if you will live in that area, you will have better life. Like that they will focus, means they will do the advertisement. But especially poor deprived people, they do not have the means good education, their skills are not sharpened, so their communication skill is not good, they are not educated, so how they will survive in that such type of towns? This is basic question. But here politicians or businessmen, they will show such type of things. So here poet is mentioning soar over their lives, what they will do, they will impose, they will impose on them, what they will impose, their lives in forcing benefits, and they will show that so many benefits are there, so they will convince them, they will persuade them using some techniques of advertisement or convincing them, because they are not educated, whatever you will say to them they will listen it, they may not analyze. What they will not analyze, what they will not understand, it is mentioned in the next line. So here, that are calculated to suit them out of their wits. So here it is out of their knowledge, out of their wisdom. So out of their wits here, out of their wisdom, out of their understanding. And what is here? That are calculated to suit them out of their already the things, whatever they will sell, suppose you can understand in real life, nearby highway or nearby such type of area, if you are getting the land in very cheap price, what you will do? Businessman, suppose you are businessman, in businessman point of view, what you will do? You will invest. Because you are getting that land in very cheap price. You may tell them that we have given the more price because the government price of that area or the land would be less. And that businessman may give you more, means more than the expectation. But what they would do, transportation facility is there. After some time when their projects will complete, the cost of that land would be more, and whatever they will produce in that area, company, they will charge the transportation charge also. So they will not face any problem because it is calculated. The benefit and all that, it is calculated, but all that things, their judgment, it is their calculated business. It will not be understood by the poor deprived people. So here it is mentioned that the benefit beast of prey sown over their lives in forcing benefits that are calculated to soothe them out of their wits. And it is out of their knowledge, out of their wisdom, out of their understanding, because they are uneducated people, illiteracy it is there. So how they will understand the things which businessmen, with business point of view, they will advertise. And by teaching them how to sleep, they sleep all day. So here, destroy their sleeping at night, the ancient way. So now, when they will sell their lands, now what they will do? They are not the skilled workers. They are not the organized workers. Means they are not working in that organized sector. They are ill, means they are having problem of illiteracy. There is no communication skill, language barrier, because they are living in such deprived area. So you can understand here also that by teaching them how to sleep, they sleep all day. And now what they are doing, you take rest in that town. All facilities are there. So this is the misguide what they are doing. They are here providing such type of advice, the guidance which is not at all good. So here teaching them how to sleep, they sleep all day and destroy their sleeping at night, the ancient way. So actually here farmers from morning to evening they are doing work and they are getting sound sleep at night. But here, when they will go in that big town, they will not have any work to do. So whatever money that businessman or the government along means, their collaboration with the government, they will purchase. And whatever money they will get, where they will spend that money, whatever they are getting of their own farm, they will just use that money in wrong way. They may go in the theater the whole day, they will sleep, and here destroy their sleeping at night, the ancient way. So they will not sleep, especially during the means the time, the ancient time. Every farmer means all the people, if you are observing those who are doing the hard work, they are sleeping at night and they are getting very nice sleep. And those who are working, especially mental work, they are taking the tablets. They are taking tablets for sleep. They are not getting the sleep. So many tension, so many problems like that you can observe. So they may use that time, the night time, they may go for means watching the movie or so many things they may do. So here actually their lives would be spoiled by the decision of the government and the businessmen, they will purchase their land and now they will not have any work to do. So the natural way of living life, they will sorn over the lives. So here the wordings are there, sorn over their lives in forcing the benefits. They will misguide them and they will show that how we are helping you and you have so many facilities so you can enjoy your life. But that would not be actual enjoyment. That would be the import, means that would be the thing which now slowly next generation, what they will do? Suppose they will get the money. How many days they will survive on that money? One day they have to switch to the work. And they will not get the work because they are not skilled workers. So their children, then they have to, what they have to do? They have to beg them. So begging, they will choose the begging or something. So in the beginning here, what is said? It would not be fair to say for a dole of bread. Because they are doing the hard work in the farm and then they are selling. But if they will sell their lands, then their condition will be like a beggars. Means future, we can foresee what will happen. So here it is indirectly also suggested to the reader that what, how their lives will change, their problems. Then in the next stanza, sometimes I feel myself, I can hardly bear the thought of so much childish longing in vain. So what would be the childish longing? So that childish desire, and here the word it is used, childish. Childish longing in vain. So how that childish longing, that desire would be in vain? So desire to observe that customers from city area, the city area people, they would come there and they will purchase, and then the lives of the people from that area, mountain area, will change. So it would be here, the thought of so much childish longing, it would be in vain. So it will not be in the reality. The sadness that lurks near the open window there. So here sadness that lurks, this is also personified, because the anything here, the sadness that lurks near the open window there. Actually the sadness here refers to the people, but here it is personified. The people, those who are living in that area, what they will do? They will wait. The whole day they will wait. So here it is mentioned, the sadness that lurks near the open window there, that waits all day in almost open prayer. And they may pray to the God that please send some customers, please send some city people to purchase the vegetables, things, or the goods, whatever it is there in that state. Otherwise, next day what will happen? They may not sell that the same vegetables, because some vegetables means 1 day, 2 days only we can keep. Afterwards, we have to throw that things in the waste. So it will be the wastage. So from morning to evening, so here that waits all day in almost open prayer, and they may observe through the windows. One vehicle is passed, the second vehicle is passed, third, fourth, and they may watch that so many vehicles are going one by one, but no one is waiting there. Some they may wait, but they are not purchasing. So here some examples, 2-3 here examples are mentioned that we can observe here. That waits all day in almost open prayer for the squeal of brakes. So here the squeal of brakes means when you will apply the force to the brake, then that voice you can observe and that is of the squeal of brakes they will listen. Then the sound of stopping car, and they will, through that window, they will observe everything. They will hear that sound, the sound of the stopping car, of all the thousand selfish cars. So here, how polished traffic it is, like the same, here polished traffic like same example it is here, transfer epithet, selfish cars. So cars will not be selfish, but here it is transport epithet. For cars, if the word selfish it is used, actually the people, those who are sitting in the cars, they are selfish. So here, selfish cars. Of all the thousand selfish cars that pass, they are just going from that area, and that sadness that lurks near the open window, and the people, they are waiting there. And how they are waiting? That waits all day in almost open prayer, and they are praying, literally they are pleading, they are pathetically pleading. It is mentioned how it is mentioned, the roadside stand that too pathetically plead, they are pathetically pleading, they are praying. What they are praying? That any person should come, the city dweller, the customer should come, and they should purchase, and they should give some money in cash. Then some examples here given. So what are that examples? Just one to inquire. One example, first example in that, just one to inquire what are the farmers' prices are. Someone may come and they may just inquire about the prices. Then, and one did stop, but only to plow off the grass. And one more, they may come. So say here some examples given in that, one more person may come, and what they would do? One did stop, but only to plow off the grass in using the yard to back and turn around. Someone may come there, and what they will do? They will destroy the grass. Means vehicle, what they will do? The grass would be there. And it is the beautiful thing that we can observe in mountain ranges. What they will do? They will take the turn or be around in that area. So they will damage the grass. Actually, in earlier also, poet is saying, the hurt to the scenery wouldn't be my complaint. It would not be complaint if they will purchase. But they are not purchasing, and what they are doing? So here it is explained that, but only to plow off grass, means they would damage that grass in using the yard to back and turn around. They may take that vehicle back, may turn, take turn, turn around that area, and they may damage the grass. Because grass is useful for the animals. So here it is, means what they will do? They will not purchase also, and they will damage the grass. So both thing here, they will again suffer. And another, to ask the way to where it was bound. So here we can think, they may come there and they may ask that how it is constructed, all things, or they may ask so many questions about the seed. So you don't ask about the seed, you think about the quality of the vegetables, quality of the things which they have kept there for the sale, and purchase it instead of comparing the things. So here, another, to ask the way to where it was bound. Then two lines, and another, one more again, and another, to ask, could they sell a gallon of gas. So gallon of gas here in America, especially here, petrol. So gallon of gas. Another to ask, could they sell it, a gallon of gas? How the poor, deprived people would have such type of, how they would sell the petrol or the things? They are not the businessmen. That roadside stands, it is just expansion of the little house. And they are poor, deprived people. So how they will keep that things with them? So your poet is now angry. They couldn't this crossly, and in anger, the poet now is angry, and in that rage, poet is mentioning that they had none. Didn't it see? Said, don't you see that thing? Didn't it see that how is their condition? How is the seed? And how are their lives? You are not observing that? You are also human being. So here humanity approach, it is important. That you are observing their condition. You are observing the condition of the seed. You are observing their pathetic condition. But then also you are asking the questions which are not expected from you. Means that such type of nonsense questions somebody may ask. So here, four examples we can notice, that some may come, may just ask the prices, may not purchase. Some may wait there, may damage the grass, and may take turns and go just as an enjoyment. Somebody may come and may ask about the seed or the things, how they have prepared that things. Means it is not just asking question or question answer session, and they are not the tourist guides to give that information. And somebody may come and may ask for the gallon of gas or the petrol. And then poet is angry. And the last stanza, no, in country money. So here country money means countryside, village especially area. So here in country money, the country scale of gain. The country scale of gain here means the economic status, economic condition, economic status of the village area. So your country scale of gain, the requisite lift of spirit has never been found. So requisite lift of spirit here, it is mentioned as a economic growth. So their status, economic status, it is, there is no growth in the economic status. So the requisite lift of spirit has never been found. So poet is mentioning here such type of requisite lift in their economic growth, it is never found, never observed, because of now they are in such type of pathetic condition. The countryside people, especially those who are living in the mountain ranges, their economic condition, it is not in progress, and that lift of requisite lift of spirit has never been found. So here it is about the economic condition. Or, so the voice of the country seems to complain. So voice of the country means the voice of the countryside people, their problem. So seems to complain, seems to, so they are complaining. Why? Because they are not getting enough money for the survival. So they are pathetically pleading, and because of that, such their voice, their problems may observe as a complaint. I can't help owning the great relief it would be. And I personally, means I have mentioned all that things, but how can I help them personally? And how can I solve the problem of all the people, those who are living in that area? How can I resolve the problem? How can I give them relief? So here, I can't help owning the great relief it would be to put these people at one stroke out of their pain. And I do not have any other such type of alternative to put them or give them the relief. So here, especially poet is talking about that, how can I give them that relief, especially the thing here in negative aspect, it is actually mentioned here that put these people at one stroke out of their pain. At one stroke means I cannot kill also them. When such type of things are there, that means their pets, due to their pathetic condition, every day there is a death in front of them. So poet in that trance started thinking negative, and then next day, as I come back into the sane, and the next day, insane means in sensations, and again he come back in the original sense, in sensation. I wonder how should like you to come to me and offer to put me gently out of my pain. So here, I wonder, poet is saying, I wonder how should I like you to come to me. So when, as a reader, suppose you wish to please me, now I am in also problem. What is that problem? So here, empathy means sympathetic way it is okay, but when others are in problem, you will also feel such type, means you will also go in the same phase. So here poet is in that empathetic way, in that empathy, poet is also facing the same problem. What is that problem? So here, offer to put me gently out of my pain. So here, my pain and their pain, two things are there. So their pain means their unhappy condition, their economic problems, or their lives are totally destroyed, their condition, their survival skills, or the means of survival, it is in danger. So their pain it is there, because they are not getting enough money for the survival. And here my pain means poet is observing their pathetic condition, and poet is not having the clear source, clear means the how to resolve that problem. There is no alternative, clear alternative to solve that problem. So here poet is indirectly convincing all the readers, those who are reading, that you keep that humanity approach, and as soon as you will read the poem, what you will do, whenever you will pass through such type of area, please visit the roadside stand and observe the quality of the product, quality of the things, and then purchase, because it is available in cheap price, and the quality also you can get. So here, offer to put me gently out of my pain, and when you will go there and when you will purchase, automatically what will happen, that poor people, those who are living in that area, poor deprived people, they will get money in cash, and I will come out from the pain which I am observing. When their daily lives will change, automatically I will also come out from that pain. The my pain means here poet's pain it is referred. So I feel that most of the things concerned with the poem, with the examples, I have discussed. I hope you will enjoy it. And such type of pathetic condition, when you will listen, when you will observe such type of areas, or you can also help the poor deprived people, you go there, do the survey, and using your personal skills or social skills, or using some other methods, or taking help of the NGO, we can help such type of poor deprived people, especially in Maharashtra or any part of the India, and we can prove that we are the actually real citizen of our India. Thank you.